गुड मॉर्निंग चिल्ड्रन, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू बिगिन विद इंडिया क्लाइमेट नेचुरल वेजिटेशन एंड वाइल्ड लाइफ. इन दिस चैप्टर वी आर गोइंग टू इंक्लूड थ्री टॉपिक्स. फर्स्ट इज क्लाइमेट, नेचुरल वेजिटेशन एंड वाइल्ड लाइफ. एंड वी विल सी हियर दैट हाउ द क्लाइमेट ऑफ अ कंट्री इट फॉर्म्स द डाइवर्सिटी इन द नेचुरल वेजिटेशन एंड द वाइल्ड लाइफ. नाउ why the climate of a country is so varied. We have different kind of climate here in India, because we have already studied in the last chapter that India has different kind of landforms are there in India. Like we have the plateau region, we have the mountain region, we have the plain region, desert areas, island groups, coastal plains. So due to that, what happens ki that we have different climatic conditions. So now let's begin with the lesson. We start from the case study, the example which is given over here. Shalya and Sumit live with their parents in Bangalore. Their school is closed for a day and they are visiting the local zoo and botanical garden with their classmates and geography teacher, who is escorting them. They see a variety of animals, plants and trees in places they are visiting. Sumit asks his teacher, "Ma'am, why is that some animals and plants are found in all parts of the country and some in certain regions only? Is the climate responsible for this diversity?" The teacher answered, "Now listen carefully while I tell you the reasons for the diversity in natural vegetation and wildlife, which is due to the wide range of weather and climatic conditions because of India's extensive size and varied physical features." Now, that before beginning with the climate part, there are two terms are there, like weather and the climate. So what is weather? Weather, it keeps on changing day to day. It keeps on changing. Suppose yesterday it was a rainy day and the windy day, so that is the weather. It changes an atmosphere in terms of temperature, moisture, wind, sun, cloud, rainfall and atmospheric pressure. So these factors are responsible for the change in the weather, like temperature, moisture, wind, sun, all these. Depending upon these factors, the weather can be sunny or cloudy, rainy or windy, hot or cold, humid or dry. Weather conditions vary from place to place. Whether it is hot and rainy where you live at the same time, in other parts of the world it could be cloudy and rainy or maybe snowing. Weather changes in a short span of time. It may be bright and sunny in the morning and cloudy in the afternoon. Thus, weather is the atmospheric condition in a particular area for a short period of time. And what is climate? Climate is a atmospheric condition in a particular area over a long period of time. So that is the difference between the weather and climate. Okay, weather, the changes occur in a short period, for a short period of time, and climate, the changes are there for a long period. Like for example, we can say the winter season, it for 2-3 months is there. Summer season is there, rainy season is there. So for 2-3 months they are there. Now, in the climate, which example we are going to see? We know that the climate of Srinagar is cold, whereas that of Chennai is hot. The climate of Rajasthan is very hot in summer and cold in winter, but in Bangalore, it is pleasant throughout the year. Now, you know, weather and climate is not the one and the same thing. So, you have to learn both the terms, weather and climate, the factors which affects the weather, and the climate, what is the difference between the weather and climate. Now, the countries of the world can be divided into different climatic zones based on the factors such as, now what are the factors which affect the climate of the country? Location, its latitude, surface relief, height above the sea level, atmospheric pressure, winds, etc. Now, we are going to, because the chapter deals with climates, now we are going to study in detail about the climate of India. India, being a vast country with huge variation in its relief features, does not fit into any one zone. However, it can be divided mainly into four climatic zones, namely alpine, subtropical, tropical, and arid. So, now what are the different seasons of India? Though divided into different climatic zones, India seem to be unified by four seasons like winter, summer, advancing monsoon or southwest monsoon or retreating monsoon. So in the geography reveals that the traditional Indian seasons are there were many seasons were there. Like for example, spring season we used to call it Vasantam, then Grisham Kal, that is summer, Varsham is that is the rainy season, Sharat Ritu, that is the autumn season, Hemantam, that is pre-winter, and Sheetam is the winter season. So now the winter starts from November to February is the winter time in all parts of India. North India, being away from the influence of the sea, experiences low temperatures. Down south has a tropical climate due to the moderating effect of the sea. The temperature can drop down to below freezing point in the higher ranges of the Himalayas, and there can be snowfall as well. At times, intense cold winds called cold waves grip the northwestern plains. Normally, winters are dry in Northern India, while occasional winter showers from temperate cyclone, the southern part, however, receives winter shower. So they're saying normally the northern part of India, that is this northern part of India, it has what a dry winter season, but the southern part of India, it receives the rainfall, winter showers. The next is summer. For summer, March, April, May and June are the summer months. It is a time when sun rays are directly over the Tropic of Cancer. Average temperature around during summer season is 32 degrees Celsius. In the western region, which has extreme climate, the temperature can shoot up to 50 degrees Celsius. So in western part of the country, it shoot up sometimes up to 50 degrees. Hot winds known as Lu sweep the states of Rajasthan, Uttar Pradesh, Haryana and Punjab. Then short-lived dusty strong wind locally called Kali Baisakhi flows through across eastern India in West Bengal, Assam and Odisha during April and June. It brings rainfall and hailstorm. There are pre-monsoon showers in Kerala. So during this season, when summer season, there are pre-monsoon showers in Kerala called mango showers. During this time, they help to ripen the mangoes, because when these showers come, the rain come, so what happens, mango, they get ripened up. In Karnataka, these showers are known as cherry blossom, and they are good for coffee cultivation too. Southwest monsoon. Now, southwest monsoon, as the word says, monsoon season, that is the rainy season. You might have heard about the monsoon season, like monsoon this year the monsoon has come little late, next year like this, you might have heard in the TV news the same thing over here. Now what they are saying, southwest. Now which is the southwest part of India? This is the south and this is the west. Southwest. So it comes from normally southwest monsoon season. Between June and September, India experiences the rainy season due to the monsoon winds. Monsoon winds are called seasonal winds. The word monsoon comes from an Arabic word called mausam, which means weather.